everyone, Nicole Cordovez here. And in today's episode, I am going to be giving you some tips on how not to sound rehearsed, whether you're on stage, doing an interview, or just speaking publicly. So in short, we will be answering the question, how do you speak from your heart? Misconception is that people are good speakers because it is natural to them. To an extent, and I feel like it's a very minimal extent, this is true. But I do believe that it's more than a natural occurrence. It has a lot of getting used to. And usually when we do public speaking, we end up sounding rehearsed, even though we didn't need to. And recently, I got a message from someone asking me, how come kahit na minemorize naman yung dapat niyang sabihin, hindi pa rin niya ma-ace talaga yung public speaking? Parang there's something lacking. So what are the things that we need to unlearn? Because growing up, diba, lumaki tayo sa isang eskwelahan na parang lahat kailangan memoryado natin. Actually, our educational system is basically built on memorizing a lot of things, but in public speaking, you need to understand more than you actually memorize. And there's a lot of inner workings going on in there. But here are some tips that I hope will help you unlearn some bad habits and learn new habits that are actually good for you. So here are three things that you can do, and the first thing you should do is to practice sounding spontaneous. This is easily caught when you record yourself like this, like what I'm doing, at mapapansin mo na parang, uy, pagka rinewatch ko to, parang sobrang, I look so stiff. And hindi nagkoconnect yung body mo, sa emotions mo, sa eye contact mo, everything. So makikita mo dito yung whole system mo, because you know, public speaking is not just moving your mouth, it's everything else. It has a lot of elements in it. So in my case, ever since I became a beauty queen and I get to re-watch my interviews on TV, dun ko nahuhuli na parang, okay, I shouldn't do that. Hey, I wasn't aware I was doing that to my face. I wasn't aware na mukha pala akong galit or sad every time I say something, even if masaya naman yung kinikwento ko. So that's one thing that you get to be aware of para you won't do it again. So when you're just at home and practicing, instead of doing it in front of a mirror where you tend to focus on your eyes lang or your mouth lang, you can record it and then see the output afterwards, and then totally, I swear, maninibago kayo. So that's the best way to practice, I feel, public speaking. And I have to put heavy emphasis on this, na practicing public speaking is the total opposite of memorizing. What do I mean by this? Kasi a good public speaker is aware of their talk points, but does not need to memorize it. Kasi yung mistake na nagagawa natin, if we memorize it word per word, if we get one word wrong, we go back automatically na, okay, we redo the sentence. Kasi we focus too much on the per word accuracy rather than the whole thought. No, witness na lang kasi natin lagi is the final stage, but there was a lot of practice behind that. And even when you practice, hindi siya parang sa script, okay, word per word, yes, ganon. Pero you also practice the emotions, like the emphasis, like, should I sound sad when I say this? Should I go slower when I say this? Dapat ba mag-add ako ng dramatic pause? So those are things that you practice before you step on stage. But if you memorize everything and really like stick to that and then tunnel vision ka talaga, like yun lang yung focus mo, kung nagkamali ka, parang you have to go back another word or another paragraph or so, the worst thing that can happen is for you to lose your train of thought and lose everything else. Because in order to be a good public speaker, even if you lose your train of thought, you won't really lose yourself on stage. You won't forget everything because you know what's coming next. Or you know yung filler na pwede mong ipasok doon in case you forget something, and then eventually recover to remember the thing you need to say. And another wonderful thing you can get out of not memorizing your answers is you can actually focus on your audience. You can learn how to read the room. So being able to read a room is like your guiding light. Na you know what to say at that moment. Kasi there are a lot of versions of a right answer. But for you to be able to really catch the pulse of your audience and know the mood of the room and know the right thing to say and how much to say about it, and it's something that you only get to enjoy experiencing if you don't memorize your answers and be in that moment with everyone you're actually talking to. The next thing that you can do is get as much experience as you can. As in, there is no job or opportunity that is too small for you to get the experience of public speaking. Accept the fact that you don't get into this thing na you're good na. I felt so crappy about my first few stints hosting. But in every stint, I have a lesson to learn. And I was eventually able to form an idea of what a client needs for a host, what an audience needs from a host as well. So start with a really small audience, be daring if you've been given the chance to speak in front of a big audience. There will be times when you fail and you don't feel satisfied with your own performance, but that's still a very good sign because you know that tomorrow you are better at what you do. And I hope you do realize that public speaking is probably the most vulnerable thing that you can do, especially since most of the time, you're talking to strangers. There's no shame in committing mistakes along the road because it is a journey of who you are. And the last thing that you can do is to be in touch with your emotion without overdoing it. Meaning like crying on cue, diba? Parang pagka sad story, kailangan ba sobrang paiyak ka na? That's what you don't do. You have to realize at this point that when you convey emotions, it's not just to show how you feel, but to share how you feel as well to your audience. This tip also has a lot to do with living in the moment and reading the room. Only now, when you're in touch with your emotions, you are also feeling the energy of everyone in the room and affecting it as well. So it's like you're bouncing off your energy with each other. So that's something you have to really be aware of and intentionally do. And once you have established that connection, that is how you properly express it, that you don't have to fake it anymore. Because you know someone's faking it if medyo off yung emotion doon sa sinasabi niya or hindi nagkoconnect sa audience, parang unsettling siya instead of inspiring. It feels a lot like crying at the beginning of a sad story that hasn't been told or laughing at a joke before you even tell the joke. So, yun yung off yung timing. Ganun yung feeling na yun. That's because you haven't really established a connection with your audience. So, parang wala kang kausap. So speaking from your heart is a lot like having a relationship with someone. Only in this case, that someone is an entire audience. So you have to talk to the audience as though you are building a relationship with them. Because at that moment, you have to make them care about you. You have to make them care about what you're about to say. So it's really this relationship na ikaw yung nag-make ng first move. So those are my tips on how to speak from your heart. For more tips on personality development and public speaking, just scroll through my YouTube channel and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you won't have to miss a single episode. This has been Nicole Cordovez na nag-iiwan ng kasabihang, it is not the crown that makes a queen, but the queen who makes a crown. And I thank you. Stay safe, everyone.